Hello everyone. Let's solve one more problem from module 1. The I section is used as a post tension pre-stress concrete beam over a simply supported span of 25 meter. Determine the permissible uniformly distributed live load the beam can carry from the following data. Initial pre-stress in steel is 1125 Newton per mm square. Loss of pre-stress 225 Newton per mm square. Permissible stress in concrete under working load is 17 Newton per mm square compression, 1.7 Newton per mm square tension. Moment of inertia of the I section about centroidal axis is 15 into 10 power 9 mm power 4. Area of cross section is 12 into 10 power 4 mm square. So these are the datas they have given. Using these datas we should find out what will be the live load can be carried by the beam. First of all, we should find out a live load acting on the beam. So what they have given in the question is, it's a simply supported beam on that UDL is acting. As in question itself they have asked us to find out the live load, I have marked it as WQ equal to question mark. So that is live load, that is unknown. Its span is 25 meter. As they have given the data of stress, that is compressive stress is 17 Newton per mm square and tension is 1.7 Newton per mm square. How did I write this form is, see, as this is a simply supported beam and it is carrying a UDL, this will be sagging. Because of this sagging in nature, compression will be at the top and tension will be at the bottom. Here in the next slide you can see this I section is clearly given in the question itself. So here almost everything they have given, all the data they have given in the figure itself, this figure is given. But here you can see y equal to, I have written some value, that value we need to calculate, and the distance from this center of the cable to the neutral axis is eccentricity of cable, small letter e, that we should find out. Only these two should be found out, other than that all these values have been given. So let me explain the stress distribution variation. See, as we know, the compression is positive, I have written plus. So value for, and it is occurring at the top, so F superior, permissible stress is nothing but F superior, F inferior and all. So F superior is 17 Newton per mm square, that is square, not into 2. So be careful while writing or while copying. Next is for tension. For tension it is negative. In PAC, always tension is represented in negative sign. So I have written minus and I have written the, shown the variation towards left side. So F inferior is 1.7 Newton per mm square. So this is a I section. Inside this I section, cable 1, that is A1, they have represented as first cable as A1. Area of the first cable is 200 mm square. Area of the, this is a second cable, so area of the second cable is 800 mm square. Okay, and the centroid distance of the first cable, centroid distance of the first cable is this dotted line. From the center, whatever I have extended this dotted line, we should measure from there to the bottom. From bottom to the top, the value is 945 mm. It is 945 mm for the centroid of the first cable. Next, the centroid of the second cable is measured from center of this cable to the bottom. So that value is 40 mm. Here it is 40 mm centroid value. For the first cable, it is 945 mm. Then the distance of this centroid from this center to the top is 25 mm. And here you can see one more dotted line. This is nothing but neutral axis. The neutral axis from the bottom, it is lying this YB. From the bottom we have measured, the YB is 546 mm, and next from the top the neutral axis is at a distance of 424 mm. This is YT 424 mm, YB 546 mm. These two also it has been given. Only this is unknown and this E value is unknown. Let's go to next slide. I have just written a data here, that is initial pre-stress in steel was 1125 Newton per mm square. That was a initial pre-stress. Next, loss of pre-stress. How much we are giving pre-stress? That was this much, and after giving, how much was the loss? That was 225 Newton per mm square was a loss. So that means what will be the final pre-stress value? That is initial minus loss will give you final pre-stress value. So if we subtract from this we will get 900 Newton per mm square. Next is area of cable. Please understand the difference. Here in the question they have given area of cross section, means whole area of I section they have given. I section value, they have area of I section they have given. Here we are calculating area of cable. Whatever cable we had, this A1 and A2, that cable value, area we are calculating. So the first cable was 200 mm square, the second cable is 800 mm square, put together it is 1000 mm square. Remember, it's a area of cable, the first cable plus second cable, you will get 1000 mm square. Next is pre-stressing force. We know stress, standard formula for stress is nothing but load by area. But here, load by area. But here we don't want stress. We already know how much is a stress. So we are calculating a pre-stressing force. So pre-stressing force P equal to stress into area of cable. Here I have highlighted. Please keep it in mind. Don't use area of I section. Use area of the cable. This is important. So I have marked it, highlighted here. So P equal to the stress, how much we got? The final stress. You should use a final stress, that is 900 into 900 Newton per mm square into 1000 mm square will give you 900 into 10 power 3 Newton. Okay. Next is area of I section. I have directly copied from the question itself, that is 12 into 10 power 4 mm square. Next is INA, that is moment of inertia for neutral axis. This is also given, that is 15 into 10 power 9 mm power 4. Next is the calculation of ZT and ZB. ZT is nothing but sectional modulus of the top. Next, ZB is sectional modulus at the bottom. So the formula for that, please be careful while using the notations. Why? Because here ZT equal to INA by YT. It is T. This here we are dealing with ZT. So here it should be YT. The next one is ZB equal to INA by YB. Centroid value or distance of neutral axis from the top or distance of neutral axis from the bottom. These two points are important or these two notations are important. As this YT and YB is directly given in the question, we can directly substitute it. That is, INA value is 15 into 10 power 9, YT is 424 mm. So if we simplify, we will get ZT as 35.37 into 10 power 6 mm cube. The next is ZB. ZB is 15 into 10 power 9 by 546. If we divide this, we will get 27.47 into 10 power 6 mm cube. Next is a calculation of dead load of beam. We know that the notation for dead load is WG. So WG equal to area of I section into density. Here also I have, in the previous slide also, I have marked here and highlighted there. And here also I have highlighted. Please note the difference. Here, as I told, for pre-stressing force, we will be using stress into area of the cable. For only for the calculation of the dead load, we will use area of I section. Only for calculation of dead load, area of I section is used. So keep this in mind. The next one is, we know area of I section, WG equal to, this should be, sorry. Yes, now it's proper. This should be 12 into 10 power 4, 10 cube whole square. Why this conversion is there is, you just observe the value. What is the value here? It is 12 into 10 power 4 mm square. It is in mm. We want in meter. So, we are just converting this denominator, whatever you can see, it is just for a conversion sake from Newton to mm. So, after converting it into density of RCC is 24 kilonewton per meter cube. So, it is 2.88 kilonewton per meter. If you want, you just add it here, that as 24 kilonewton per meter cube for density of concrete. Next is moment due to dead load. The moment due to dead load is standard formula for a, you can first you observe here, that is WgL square by 8. Usually we know for a simply supported beam carrying a UDL, the bending moment at the center is WL square by 8. Okay. So, as this is a simply supported beam, the formula will be exactly same, WL square by 8, but we need to do some modification with the notations. Here Mg is nothing but moment due to dead load. So, as we are using dead load here, so the notation should be WG. For moment, Mg. For the load, it is Wg. So, the value is 2.88 kilonewton per meter into its complete length is 25 meter square by 8. You will get 225 kilonewton meter. Be thorough with the units. For load, what should be the unit? For moment, what should be the unit? See, you can observe one thing. It is 2.88 kilonewton per meter. Whenever you get this per meter, it is clearly understood that it's a UDL. when you have a point load, you will get only kilonewton, but when you have a UDL, you will get kilonewton per meter. For moment, it's kilonewton meter. Next is about location of centroidal, sorry, location of center of gravity for cable from bottom. Why I have mentioned that as from the bottom is, I'm just calculating all the values from the bottom, from keeping that as a reference, I'm calculating it. So I have just mentioned it as from bottom. So y bar standard formula for this is, see, you can read out here, y bar is nothing but it's a centroidal axis due to the cables present at the top and bottom. We get a centroidal axis. So this is a centroidal axis of a whole I section. Earlier what we had got, this dotted line, this dotted line and this dotted line is nothing but centroid of this particular element. Now whatever we are calculate, sorry, now whatever we are calculating this y bar, this is for a whole system because of these two cables present at the top and at the bottom. For that, the standard formula is, it is generally you can write it as sigma ay by sigma a, that is capital A in the denominator, in the numerator it is sigma small letter a into y. You can use a formula like that, notation like that, or directly you can expand like this and you can write it. See, here you can clearly see I have mentioned it as a1 y1 plus a2 y2 whole divided by a1 plus a2. It's clearly, we can clearly understand that a1 means it is for a first cable, a2 is for the second cable, and y1 refers to centroidal distance of for a first cable, and y2 is centroidal distance for the second cable. So it is clearly written, so there is no confusion in this formula. So the a1 is 200, that is this one, I'm talking about this 200, and y1 is this value from here up to here. The centroidal distance of this element is measured from the bottom, so it is 945 mm. You can see 200 into 945, first element is over, plus second element. The second element area is 800 mm² and its distance from the centroidal distance from the bottom is, it is 40 mm. So multiply that 800 into 40, whole divided by area of the first cable plus second cable, you will get the answer as, or y bar as, 221 mm. This is a centroidal axis for a whole system. So now you should go back and you should measure or mention in the diagram like this. I have written here. So y equal to 221 mm. This is what I have mentioned in the diagram. Next is E. Small letter E is nothing but eccentricity. If you want, you can add a, one second. Yes, small letter E stands for eccentricity. So how to calculate this eccentricity is, we know YB value. This 546 is nothing but YB minus this Y bar will give you the distance from the cable, center of the cable to the, see, here. From here to here, how much we got? It is 221. what is the YB value? The distance from the bottom to the neutral axis is 546. So 546 minus 221 will give you this value. Here it is nothing but E value, eccentricity from the center to the neutral axis. So that is E value. E is nothing but eccentricity, that is 325 mm. The next slide is about, question itself, directly they have given the two different type of stresses, that is compressive stress and tensile stress. So we will use both the stresses and we will find in this equation, we have in F superior or F inferior, we have MQ term. MQ term is nothing but moment due to live load. From using both the formula, we should find out what is the moment due to live load. Then using this moment, we can calculate what is a what is a live load. By using this moment of live load, we can calculate load due to live load. Okay, so they have, please pay attention here. The first point is they have given it as compressive stress, where this will occur because it is a sagging, compression will be here. I'm talking about this because it's a sagging, compression will be at the top. So this is nothing but F superior. This is tension is occurring at the bottom. So this is nothing but F inferior. Like this, I have used a notation F superior and F inferior. Okay, so for F superior is nothing but 17 newton per mm square. We have a, for F superior we have a standard formula, just write it down. As compression is at the top, please pay attention to these notations. I'm using it as ZT, it is for the top. Okay, next, we know all the values, that is P value and as well as A value. A value, please, here also this is important. This is not a area of cable, this is area of complete I section. Keep this in mind, this is also a important point. Okay, so P value we know, A is also known. Again, substitute these two values, we know for value formula for the second one. Here there is a slight mistake. This is not plus, this is minus. Okay, now it's proper. Fine, the second term is over. Again, for the third term, mg value, that is moment due to dead load, we know, substitute that, ZT substituted, plus mq, moment due to live load, we don't know that. How much should be the live load, moment due to live load, we don't know that itself we are going to calculate. So that is unknown. By ZT value, equate that to 17. Okay, so when we equate this to 17, we will get MQ as 403.52 into 10 power 6 newton mm. This is MQ value due to compressive stress. Next is due to tensile stress. How much will be NQ value, we should find out. And one more important point is, please remember this, it is tensile. So here we should take minus 1.7 while calculating. In question, they have not given it as minus 1.7, nothing like that. They have clearly mentioned it is a tensile stress or tension. Okay, when they have mentioned it as a tensile stress or tension, that means it is clearly understood that we should go for a negative sign here. But in question, directly they have not given minus sign here. So this is also one more point to remember. So I have taken F, this is F inferior. There is one more correction. Now it's proper. See, as I said, go for a negative sign when they give tensile stress. So F inferior equal to, this is a standard formula, P by A plus PE by ZB minus MQ by ZB, sorry, MG by ZB minus MQ by ZB equal to minus 1.7 Newton per mm square. Okay. So substitute all the values and equate it to minus 1.7. And here one more point to be remembered, that as I said, as tension or tensile stress is at the bottom, we are dealing with the bottom layer. So it should be, notation should be ZB. Here for the top it is ZT. So substitute all the values here. We will get MQ as 320.22 into 10 power 6 Newton mm. See, you can clearly see, because of compressive stress, we got MQ value as 403. Because of tensile stress, we got MQ as 320. And in between these two, which one is a least moment due to live load, we should consider that for a calculation of live load, for a live load calculations. So which one is the least here? It is 320 is a least value. So I'm choosing this 320 least value for finding out a dead load, sorry, load due to live load. So I have clearly written, see here, therefore taking least live load moment equal to 320.22 into 10 power 6 Newton mm. So this is a least value, consider that. So we know the standard formula has moment at the center in simply supported beam. If you want, you can just go for small q here. As we are dealing with a, sorry, yes, it's perfect. As we are dealing with a live load, we can go for, we should use these notations, that is WQ L square by 8. So we know this moment at the center. For this, you should consider this 320. So 320.22 into 10 power 6 into 2. From the denominator, you take it, multiply to numerator, whole divided by this L square I have written. So WQ is nothing but 4.10 kilonewton per meter. This is live load which the beam can carry, is this much, that is 4.10 kilonewton per meter. Points to be remembered here is, once again, just we will go for a revision. This is a question. They had given initial pre-stress and the loss and other data they have given. So to when they give initial pre-stress and the loss, we should subtract initial minus loss to get a final pre-stress. We should be using this pre-stressing value, and we should calculate area of the cable. We should use area of the cable value for finding out pre-stressing force. Next, for calculating ZT and ZB, we should always use INA by YT and YB. It depends on it's a top layer or bottom layer. We should pay attention to that. The next thing is WG. For calculation of dead load, we should consider only a area of I section, not area of the cable. It is, area of I section is clearly given in the question itself. Next is the location, that is Y bar. y bar formula we know. While taking y1 and y2, be careful, I am measuring from the bottom, so I have mentioned it as bottom. So be careful there. The next thing is, we should calculate MQ, that is moment due to live load, by using both the stresses given, that is compressive stress as well as tensile stress. In tensile stress, in question they had not given it as minus, but they have mentioned it as tension or tensile. So as soon as we see this term tensile tension while calculating, we should use it as minus 1.7. Minus is important or negative sign is important. So using these two stresses, that is 17 and minus 1.7, we will get different M values. So in these two MQ values, that is moment due to live load, which one will be the least value, we should consider that for the calculation of the load, live load calculation. So we know the formula for simply supported beam carrying a UDL, that is WL square by 8. So we know moment value here. So we substitute it, we get WQ as 4.10 kilonewton per meter. Thank you.